So, Coach, you're the father of Brandon, of Omar, of Omara. Introduce everybody that's here with us.
Nelson Hampton.
What's up, Nelson?
How you doing? How
What's your role in the team?
I'm a boxer. I'm a fighter.
Oh, that's badass. I thought you were part of the team, but you are a fighter. What's the record, Nelson?
7-3.
That's badass. And who are you fighting on this card?
Jose Venezuela.
Oh, with the Team Benavides?
Yeah.
Ryu. It's a great fight.
Yes, sir.
But you look tall for that weight class.
Oh, yes, sir. You already know.
That's badass. What's your Instagram?
Team Hot Hands.
Why Hot Hands?
I follow you, too.
Thank you. I'll follow you back. Why Hot Hands?
Just my hands are hot. You know what I mean? Don't touch them.
Okay. Who's standing near you?
My assistant, coach, Jesus Montalvo.
Jesus, how are you feeling today?
Good.
What makes you good as a coach?
Because I'm good.
What does he add? Like, is he another pair of eyes? It always helps.
Exactly, yeah. He pushes them more than me. Like, when I'm busy, he's over there working with Brandon, with Nelson, with everybody that's there. I mean, he's my right-hand man, and he's doing a great job.
And, of course, you're here. Your son's headlining. Do you guys like the banner? Tell me about that. Do you see your face?
Yeah. I mean,
they come out clean. Is there a way to roll it up and take it back home?
I was dreaming always about my sons having a main event and having like a banner like that. And look at that right there. It's right there. Dreams come true. Hard work.
How was the press conference?
It was good. It was really entertaining.
And we are 48 hours from fight night, 24 hours from the weigh-in. Most fighters right now want to strangle someone. You're chilling. You're smiling. Why?
I mean, because I had a great training camp, you know, my diet was well. I mean, obviously, I can't wait to eat as well, but, I mean, everything's good, you know. We're happy, and we're excited, and we can't wait.
Obviously, you started your kids in boxing. Did you ever think you'll make not one champion, but two champions? It's hard. It's hard to make one.
No, it is. Believe me, it is. It's like having two champions under the same roof. I doubt it with Brandon because he was so skinny, so wimpy.
He looks innocent too.
Yes. And look at this guy, man. He proved
he's a killer.
Well. I would be working with Omar, focusing on Omar. He would be, look, Dad, look at me, Dad. And oh, no, Brandon, you're too wimpy, you're too this and that. And he trained himself practically the first times. So he caught my attention when he was, you know, dropping kids to the body. Like at 15, 14, he was hitting hard to the body. And then I started, you know what, man, Brandon's looking good and very disciplined. So, look at where we're at now. WBA interim world champion fighting for the WBC now, challenging Neri.
It's a major fight. The whole world's tuning in. Luis
yes,
Neri is a big name.
Yes, sir.
He has, you know, he's like a personality because his his activities on and off
sir.
The ring, but it's still a big fight.
Yes,
and what do you guys think? What's your prediction?
Oh, I predict a knockout.
What round?
I've sparred Brandon, and for 122, he's too strong.
He is like a 154 pounder.
Too strong, so I predict round 7.
Brandon on the 6.
I think Brandon's gonna win. I don't know by knockout, but I'm sure Brandon's gonna win. He eats too hard.
Of course, Brandon's gonna win. I think he'll finish him. I think he'll put a lot of pressure, and I don't think Neri will be able to take it.
I feel like I'm gonna take him to the deep end and just finish him.
Where does the power come from?
Genetics.
Your mom or your dad?
Stepdad.
I don't know. I think it's just genetic hard work.
That's my mom.
And technique. Technique's very important.
Huh?
And you taught him the technique.
Yes. Yes. I was a street fighter myself, and I had power in both hands. I couldn't get to be a professional fighter or an amateur fighter, but I could hit hard, believe me.
You're from Texas, of course.
Yes.
Did you grow up in the same city?
Yeah, I was born in Mexico, just across the border, and now we're living in... I was born in Figueroa, Tamaulipas. Now we live in Huastlaco, Texas, and that Mexican blood is in Brandon. My ex-wife, also from Mexico, so he's got Mexican blood and warrior's blood.
Brandon, if we put your dad on one of the celebrity cards, which celebrity would be a good fight for him? You know, YouTube is very popular now, boxing and everything.
Chardon.
Mayweather.
You and Floyd?
No.
He's fighting Logan.
No, Guerrero's no. And the Danny.
Danny Garcia's dead.
Angel?
Angel.
we're cool.
Shout out to Angel. He's
we're
a good
friends.
Dude, man.
Yeah, they're friends. But...
We can do an exhibition, Angel.
Call him up.
Call out Angel.
Hey, I'm sorry.
No, you're good. But what's your philosophy as a coach? Obviously, you have success for a certain reason. What is it that... Your sons win and win and win.
I guess constant work, and I'm always after them. I'm always giving them advice, you know. I don't know. It's something that I don't like to lose, and I like for them to lose. And they have their you know, that mentality, especially Brandon. So I guess that's like, it's in his blood, you know? I don't know, it's something they grew up with.
What can you guys tell me about your dad as a coach? What makes him so good?
I think that it's that, like, he obviously, we're his kids, right? Brandon's his son, Omar, they're both fighters. No one wants to see their son or their kid lose. So I feel like my dad as a coach, he's going to care a lot about Brandon and protect him and do the best that he can so he can get up in the ring and always come out victorious. I feel like no one's going to care more about you than your family. So having your family around is really important.
Listen, I'm going to tell you, it's very hard to take a kid and teach him from throwing a punch to winning a title and then defending and winning. It's not easy. Not everybody could do it. There's a lot of famous coaches that didn't do it. Yes, but let me ask you this. Who right now do you have as your top five pound for pound?
Salvador Sanchez.
Okay.
Julio Cesar Chavez.
Okay.
Marc Antonio Barrera.
Okay. You just have Mexicans on the list? No, they're great fighters. Yeah, I'm not saying they're
Marquez.
Not. Marquez?
You can say Floyd Mayweather.
Floyd.
Muhammad Ali.
Okay.
Sugar Ray Leonard.
That's eight. Two more.
Finito Lopez and, Canelo.
That's amazing. That's all time. What about currently? Who do you have right now as the top five? Active.
Active. Canelo, definitely. Maybe Terrence Crawford, Spencer. And then I like Benavidez a lot.
David Benavidez?
Yeah, David Benavidez.
And the fifth one. Who do you think? Is it Brandon Figueroa?
Maybe
after the fight?
Maybe after the fight. No, maybe...
I mean, yeah, you have Tank, you have Teofimo, you have...
Maybe
Teofimo. Teofimo?
Yeah, he's talking about them good.
He's doing big things. So, if you had a dream fight, who would it be? One guy.
A dream fight?
Yeah.
To make money? Mayweather.
Yeah, I'll say Mayweather, yeah.
But from the active fighters, he's retired.
Active?
Yeah.
I'll say Teofimo Lopez. Yeah, it's a good fight.
It's a great fight. He has all the belts. He shocked the world with Loma. Mm-hmm. What do you think of Loma Nakatani?
It's going to be a great fight.
That's the guy who beat Verdejo.
The guy that beat Verdejo? Yeah, no, it's going to be a great fight.
Up, right? Yeah. Fortunately, sad story, yeah. Who you got, Loma or Nakatani?
I feel Loma.
Andy Ruiz or Tyson Fury? I agree with you. What do you think?
That one's tough, but I'm going to go for Andy.
That's going to be a tough one. I think Fury. I saw Andy Ruiz. I think he was a great fight with Arreola. And I think Arreola hit the better. He kind of like rocked him a couple of times. And I think Fury hits a lot harder than Arreola.
Tyson Fury.
I got Andy.
I got Fury because of the reach.
Okay.
And the height difference.
And the last question, message to all the fans back home if they're watching, all the way from Texas to here.
All our fans, I mean, stay tuned for Saturday. It's going to be a great fight. One of our own,
Showtime.
Brandon Figueroa on Showtime Saturday. It's going to be a great fight. We're going to have two belts coming home.
There you have it. Stay tuned. FIGUEROA.com. Reporting. Hold on, let me take a picture for Instagram really quick.